Hello and welcome. Today we are taking a look at a game called The Stanley Parable. As many of you may already know, this game started off as a Half-Life 2 mod and is currently out on Steam and on sale, so recommend checking it out, definitely. Without further babbling, let's begin. The end is never.
This is the story of a man named Stanley. Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427. Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427 and he pushed buttons on a keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor on his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order. This is what employee 427 did every day of every month of every year.
I apologize.
And although others might have considered it soul-rending, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly for this job. And Stanley was happy. And then one day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget. He had been at his desk for nearly an hour when he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow. No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi. Never in all his years at the company had this happened, this complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk and stepped out of his office.
Right. Oh, we can move around now. Oh, what's that? Okay. Oh, what?
But Stanley simply couldn't handle the pressure. What if he had to make a decision? What if a crucial outcome fell under his responsibility? He had never been trained for that. No. This couldn't go any way except badly. The thing to do now, Stanley thought to himself, is to wait. Nothing will hurt me. Nothing will break me. In here I can be happy forever. I will be happy. Stanley waited. Hours passed, then days. Had years gone by? He no longer had the ability to
open the door.
But the one thing he knew for sure, beyond any doubt, was that if he waited long enough, the answers would come. Eventually, someday, they would arrive. Soon, very soon now, this will end. He will be spoken to. He will be told what to do. Now it's just a little bit closer. Now it's even closer.
Where?
Here it comes.
What? What? What just happened? Alright, that was an interesting event. Just close that.
All his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
Where is everyone?
Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
Yes, that's a good idea. Why can't I see outside? Huh, that's weird. Can't open any doors. Open this one? No. Okay. Sorry. Alright.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Did I? Why should I listen to you? Maybe I just want to go back to my office. It's nice in there. Alright. Well, I ain't listening to you.
This was not the direct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Yeah, that's probably it. Oh, look at this place.
Yes, truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all, just to spend
beautiful
a few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room. Stanley simply stood here, drinking it all in.
Can I drink this coffee? I'm clearly a number one dad. Alright, whatever.
Maybe yes. Get a soda? Yes. Really, really worth it being here in the room. A room so utterly captivating that even though all your co-workers have mysteriously vanished, here you sit looking at these chairs and some paintings. Really worth it.
All right, calm down.
But
I'll move
eager
on.
To get
Jeez.
Back to business, Stanley took the first open
He's
door.
He's not a big
left.
Fan of my. What is this? But what's in there? No, screw you. Going in here.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
I follow my own directions. I don't follow your one direction. Do not lie. If you are lying right now, stop. Alright? I don't think I'm lying, though. As far as I'm aware. Where are we? What does this company do? There's a bunch of boxes and some trucks down there. I'm afraid I'm gonna fall, so I'm gonna not do that. Warning, do not jump from the cargo lift while it is in motion. Will cause death. Penalty for misuse of cargo lift, $1,000. Penalty for jumping off cargo lift, $5,000. Alright, find me if you want!
But in his eagerness to prove that he is in control, no one gets to tell him what to do, Stanley leapt from the platform and plunged to his death. Good job, Stanley. Everyone
Woo!
Thinks you are very powerful.
I won! Right? Yeah. Aw, alright, fine. Alright.
All of his co-workers
Freaking
were gone. What
jerk,
could it mean?
Though.
Stanley decided to go to the
yeah,
meeting room.
Yeah,
Perhaps
yeah.
he had simply missed a memo.
I get the message you're trying to send me. Jeez. Stop disobeying orders.
Stanley came to a set of two open
Fine,
doors.
I'll go on the
he
left.
Entered the door on his left.
413. Ooh, look at that picture. It's beautiful. Alright. What's over here?
Yet there was not a single person here either.
Tips for not getting
Feeling
fired.
A wave of disbelief, Stanley decided to go to his boss's office, hoping he might find
Oh, I was reading that.
There.
How does it solve a dispute with a coworker? Take out all passively aggressively on coworkers. Resent coworkers for not supporting you more. Ah, dang it. Using slides to assure employees that everything is okay. Make sure your slide has a slick blue graphic in the header and throw some malevolent in the text. This will ensure Yeah, screw you two. Quit moving too quickly. Broom closet. This is obviously where we want to go.
Stanley stepped into the broom closet, but there was nothing here.
Nope.
So he turned around and got back on
This
track.
Is the best room ever. There's a wrench. Alright, fine. Jeez. What?
Coming to a staircase, Stanley walked upstairs to his boss's office.
Fine. God. Where's my boss's office? Oh, it's fancy up here. Holy. Is that it? Executive bathroom? Dude, I need to go in there. I gotta pee. Jeez. Hello, sir.
Stepping into his manager's office, Stanley was once again stunned to discover not an indication of any human life.
All right.
Shocked, unraveled, Stanley wondered in disbelief who orchestrated this. What dark secret was being held from him? What he could not have known was that the keypad behind the boss's desk guarded the terrible truth that his boss had been keeping from him. And
what?
So the boss had assigned it an extra secret PIN number. 2845. But of course, Stanley couldn't possibly have known that. Yet incredibly, by simply pushing random buttons on the keypad, right. Stanley happened to input
whoa, whoa,
the correct
what?
Code
What's
by
happening?
Sheer luck.
It's happening.
Amazing.
Whoa.
He stepped into the newly opened passageway.
Screw that, I'm the boss now. I'm gonna sit in my... I can't move the chair! I just want to sit in my new chair and look over my vast wealth. Maybe take some phone calls on the rotary phone. Look at some classified files. Drink some nothing, because there's nothing in those glasses. Stare at my beautiful... I don't even... Is that... That's just industrial waste. Alright, that's a beautiful picture. Where are we? What does this company do? I feel like this is important now. Oh. Oh, looks like we're going down. Loading. Loading.
Descending deeper into the building, Stanley realized he felt a bit peculiar. It was a stirring of emotion in his chest, as though he felt more free to think for himself, to question the nature of his job.
The point of my job?
For years, it had never occurred to him. This question would not go unanswered for long.
Oh. Lights are out. Is this a caution zone? There's someone gonna like come down and hit me with the...
Stanley walked straight ahead through the large door that read Mind Control Facility.
No, I'm gonna go with escape. Screw that.
Although
I played Portal.
Had the word escape written on it. The truth was that at the end of this hall, Stanley would meet his violent death.
Don't care. I ain't going back. I played Portal. I know how this works.
The door behind him was not shut. Stanley still had every opportunity to turn around and get back on track.
Screw you.
At this point, Stanley was making a conscious, concerted effort to walk forward and willingly confront his death.
Yep. What are you gonna do about it? Yep. I ain't going into your mind control facility. Screw you! What?
As the machine whirred into motion, and Stanley was pushed closer and closer to his...
Oh god, I made a bad choice!
His life had been of no...
I have made bad choices in life.
Stanley can't see the bigger picture. He doesn't know the real story. Trapped forever in his narrow vision of what this...
Oh Jesus!
Perhaps his death was of no...
Oh god!
Like plugging the eyeballs...
No!
So he resigned.
I don't want to go.
Accepted this violent end.
No, there's a ledge. Life. Oh Jesus. Oh. I don't want to die. No. Oh.
Farewell, Stanley, cried the narrator.
Oh.
As Stanley was led helplessly into the enormous metal jaws. In a single visceral instant, Stanley was obliterated.
No.
As the machine crushed.
I don't want to die.
His body.
No, somebody help me! The Stanley Parable.
And yet it would be just a few minutes before Stanley would restart the game back in his office as alive as ever.
What is over here?
What exactly did the narrator think he was going to accomplish?
Oh. Did I finish it?
When every path you can
walk has
been created for you long in advance, death becomes meaningless, making life the same. Do you see now?
What?
Do you see that Stanley was already dead from the moment he hit start?
Oh, so this is mapping out everything I did, is it? I think? So the two doors, the set of two open doors that was the very first concrete piece of the Stanley Parable's design. Once the room was created, the rest of the game emerged as an extension of it, an exploration of the contradiction the room posed. Corridor. The pacing of this opening section was important to get right. This corridor has been moved and altered to make sure the player reaches the two doors in a good time. Office layout. This blueprint shows the office from the beginning of the game. The path from Stanley's office was to the two doors was the first part of the game that was built. Sections have been added and altered throughout development, though the core layout remains almost identical to the first iteration. Oh, so this is actually just everything that I started out with. I started in here, over at that computer there. Then I went through here. And I kept going, and I kept going, and then I made my choice that started the choices of the game. Well, what's over here? The office. One, two, three. None of these doors open. Button sounds.
Oh.
I don't know, I like that button for some reason. Filing cabinets? So this is just showing like everything that the game is made up of. Nature paintings. I know that one! I stared at that one. That was beautiful. This game is awesome! Office computers. Oh, I can shut them off too. Ha! Take that. Credits. This game is amazing. What's over here? I see stuff over there, but what's over here? Office clock. Oh, the clock moves. Oh, that's amazing. That's awesome. Oh, dang. What is this? Mind control facility. Underground. An early version of the underground portrait in the game. Oh, what's this?
Where were all of his co-workers? Oh, I don't know. How about they're throwing a surprise party for him for all his button pushing? Does that sound plausible to you?
Huh? Huh? Oh man, I think I beat the game. Oh. Boss's office. Oh, so it changed several times before the final ones. This is awesome. Freedom ending? What? There's a freedom ending? Oh wait, it says that was in alpha. Is there still one though? Countdown desk. There's a countdown ending. Freedom ending as in beta. Dang. Countdown room. What countdown room? I haven't been there. Oh, look, my office. Oh, so these are the different versions of the office that existed. That's cool. Okay, let's go to the exit. I could spend... I saw the exit somewhere. Oh, yeah, it's in here. Look, I could spend forever on this game. But... probably shouldn't. The exit is this way.
Oh, look at these two. How they wish to destroy one another. How they wish to control one another. How they both wish to be free.
The switch?
Can you see? Can you see how much they need one another?
I don't know.
Perhaps not. Sometimes these things cannot be seen. But listen to me. You can still save these two. You can stop the program before they both fail.
Push oh, so I'm not done?
Press quit. There's no other way to beat this game. As long as you move forward, you'll be walking someone else's path. Stop now and it'll be your only true choice. Whatever you do, choose it. Don't let time choose for you. Don't let time
Oh. I let time choose for me. What happened? Did I win? All right. Good. That happened. Let me know in the comments below if you want me to keep playing this. I mean, I'll probably do another run through with or without recording, but if you enjoy the series, let me know. See ya.